In this lesson, we will learn how to use if in JavaScript. So let's go ahead and say declare a variable where num1 is equal to say 10. So now we want to check whether this number is say greater than 5 or not, whether num1 is greater than 5 or not. So we can say if num1 is greater than 5. Now, if this condition is true, so this is a condition, if num1 is greater than 5, then let's say we will say document dot write, and we can say num1 is greater than 5. So we just printing this, and just so that we are able to check it better, let's just say document dot write num1 is equal to, and we just write the value of num1 and we just put a break. So let's run this code. Let's see what do we get. So when we run this code, we are saying num1 is 10. That's the value we gave it. And num1 is greater than 5. So this condition was true. num1 is greater than 5. And hence it went in and printed this. So if this condition is true, it will go into this if block. Suppose we give num1 the value 3. Now let's run it and let's see what happens. So num1 is 3 and there is nothing here. Why is there nothing here? Because this condition is false. So because this condition is false, it did not go in and execute this. So this is if. So we could have also said, so let's say if we write another if here, if say num1 is greater than 20, we will print num1 is greater than 20. Let's go ahead and run it again. We don't get any print statement because both these conditions are false. num1 greater than 5 is false. num1 greater than 20 is false. Suppose we give num1 the value 10. Let's go ahead and run it. What do we get? num1 is 10. We get this print statement. num1 is greater than 5. We don't get the other one because it's obviously false. So here we are checking the value of num1. Similarly, suppose we want to check whether num1 is odd or even. So let's say we say where rem is equal to num1 percentage 2. So percentage is the remainder operator. So num1 percentage 2 will give us the remainder when num1 is divided by 2. So now when is a number even? When the remainder is 0 when we divide it by 2. So we can now say if rem is equal to 0. So if this is 0, we can say document dot write num1 is an even number. So we can say that, and we can also say that if rem is 1, then it is an odd number. So if it is odd, we know the remainder will be 1. So let's go ahead and run it. What do we say? It's printing on the same line. Why? Because we did not do the BRs. So let's just put the BRs after all our prints so that it's easier to read it. So let's go ahead and run it again and let's see what do we get. We get num1 is greater than 5, yes, and num1 is an even number. Suppose we give num1 the value 7. Now what do we get? num1 is 7, num1 is greater than 5, and num1 is an odd number. Why? Because remainder is 1. We could have also used else here. So if this condition is not true, we can say else and say this. So if this condition is true, then num1 is an even number, else num1 is an odd number. And here also we could have said, say else, let's say we write here document dot write num1 is less than or equal to 5. So it would also be false when it is equal to, so we have put in here. So if you look at this code, what are we saying? So if num1 is greater than 5, it will write this. If this condition is false, it will go into the else block. So if num1 is say 3, what do we get here? We should get the else, which is num1 is less than equal to 5. Let's say we don't need this part of the code right now. Let me delete it. And the second part would be, what will be the value of rem? 3 percentage 2 will be 1. So if condition, is this true? No, it is not true. So it will go into the else block here. Let's run it. So we get num1 is less than or equal to 5. Num1 is an odd number. Let's say we give it the value 11. Now what will happen? We will get num1 is greater than 5 and num1 is an odd number. So this condition is true. If this condition is true, it does not go into the else block. And here, this condition is false, so it goes into the else block and prints it. So this is how we use if and else in JavaScript.